the best companies out there, easy to do business with companies, have liberated their front line to think one step ahead for their customers. Some of them have done this with data science. Others have done this just through gut instinct. But they've told their representatives, look, if you're solving a customer issue and you know that there's a high probability that a customer is going to call back about a related downstream issue, take the extra time and solve that issue too. Okay, we call this forward resolution. Let me share with you a quick story, a personal story about how this happened with me. Does everyone know what this is? Dyson vacuum. How many people have a Dyson? Yeah? I've got one too. I think these things are priced like they're made of gold, but it's just expensive British molded plastic, it turns out. And I found this out the hard way because I rammed my Dyson into, I clipped the wooden leg of my dining room table, and I knocked this part off the side, which I later learned was the dust filter cover, which it also turns out is a critical component of the Dyson vacuum cleaner, because without it, it's not just that it doesn't work, it actually sprays dirt all over your house. So it's not just unproductive, it's counterproductive. And so I called Dyson up to order a replacement part. Great interaction with this rep. She took me to the website, a couple questions, we diagnosed the model I had. Then she took me to the exploded diagram, showing all the parts and pieces. And we very quickly understood that it was the dust filter cover, part 21 XJC that I needed. That's a great example of first contact resolution. And if it ended there, I would have been thrilled, right? But here's what happened next. So she said, I'm actually going to send you two of those. And I was like, hold on a second. I don't have to pay for one. You're not going to charge me for two. I only need one. I'm an idiot, but I only broke it once. I don't need two. And she said, actually, in my experience, customers who call us up to buy this replacement part, what they don't realize is it's actually a little bit tricky to install. There are these little pins and tabs all along the circumference of this thing, and that if you force it, you break those pins and tabs, and when you do that, you gotta resort to duct tape or calling us back. And so what we found is it's actually better to give you two now. So you can try with one. If you get it wrong, you got a backup. If you get it right, throw it in the parts bin. Don't send it back to us, we don't want it. Keep it for next time you ram your Dyson into your dining room table, knucklehead. So, and so at this point, I was just totally fascinated because I study this stuff for a living, and I'm asking, well, doesn't that cost you a lot? How, what are the economics of that? Like, doesn't it take more time, and does it justify the extra time and the expense of sending a spare part? And it was at that moment she said, have I fully resolved your issue today? But she did answer this question. She said, look, no, actually, we've done the math, and it's actually cheaper for us to send you a second part than it is for you to call us back. And we also know it's way less frustrating for our customers. So think one step ahead for your customers, because that's what easy to do business with companies do. This is not hard stuff. You can use data science, machine learning to do it. You can just do it through gut instinct. Your most tenured reps know, if I solve this issue, I'm probably going to get a call back about this other issue, unless I forewarn the customer this might happen to them. So think one step ahead. Don't play checkers with your customer. Play chess. All right?